For Raymond Davios, a visit to Port-au-Prince's largest jail is a deeply emotional journey. He was locked up for months here, a prisoner of Jean-Claude Duvalier's regime. His only crime to stand in opposition of a man the world knows as Baby Doc. He says these scars are from severe beatings he received at the hands of Duvalier's feared militia. In all, Raymond was arrested 17 times, but tells us he feels lucky that he wasn't executed like thousands of others. During Jean-Claude Duvalier's 15-year rule, human rights groups say tens of thousands of Haitians were tortured and killed. And for Raymond, it's almost too much to be back here for the first time in 30 years.
As I'm talking to you, it's like I'm reliving my whole story, and that's what I get emotional. All my life, I've been afraid of this area because it makes me remember the pain of when I was in jail.
This statue symbolizes Haiti's hopes for lasting peace. And despite what Raymond has been through, he remains optimistic that those in the Duvalier regime will be brought to justice. But the legal system here moves incredibly slowly and it's highly politicized. Nevertheless, human rights groups say they'll continue the fight, no matter how long it takes.
But the death of Jean-Claude Duvalier has left many victims feeling cheated. He died in Port-au-Prince a free man, but the case against him and his government may still go on.
Duvalier was not alone. There were so many people who were involved in Duvalier regime, and then they will continue to prosecute those people.
For victims of Duvalier's regime, these are trying times. Haiti still has plenty of Duvalier supporters, and justice for those who suffered may be a long way off. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, Port-au-Prince, Haiti.